how well players play when mom and dad are there and things go well. Well, here we have Dave Brown and John Kordick, as we had been able to predict from the stoppage of play.
Ooh, Dave
a couple
Brown.
Of southpaws. Boy, Brown was really going for the left uppercut there too, wasn't he?
Dave Brown has a decided reach advantage, and he really locked John Kordick out. Now look what he's got. He's got his hand held behind him. When you talk heavyweight, folks, you're talking these two guys. What a great battle, stand-up battle all the way. Well, Dave Brown said his role was pretty simple in the Flyers organization, and it looks like John Kordick has a bloody nose. You bet he does. So my role is simple. If there's a problem on the ice, I go out and fix it. And he may have just fixed a problem that was brewing as far as John Kordick taking liberties against some of the smaller Flyers a little earlier. Here's how it started. They just went out to the point together, and then it was a matter of, okay, let's not ask any questions. We kind of figured it would happen. Oh, Kordick just put his head down without getting a grip first. Boy, oh boy. And you can, I think he's already been hit. Dave Brown might have hit him with the first one or two punches right in the nose with those uppercuts.
Ooh, he was really trying to score with that one as he pulled away, wasn't he?
Yeah, but John Kordick, well, you know, as soon as he put his head down, he really couldn't see what he was grabbing or where he was grabbing. And this is when Dave Brown, now, do you think that's not a tough position to be in? Got a half Nelson on him at the same time, but still facing him. You can see that Dave Brown has him locked out so well. Kordick's punches weren't coming within 6 inches of Brown's face.
Third flyer. So their parents in the stands, and we've talked so often about how well players play when mom and dad are there and things go well. Well, here we have Dave Brown and John Kordick, as we had been able to predict from the stoppage of play.
Ooh, Dave
a couple
Brown.
Of southpaws. Boy, Brown was really going for the left uppercut there too, wasn't he?
Dave Brown has a decided reach advantage, and he really locked John Kordick out. Now look what he's got. He's got his hand held behind him. When you talk heavyweight, folks, you're talking these two guys. What a great battle, stand-up battle all the way. Well, Dave Brown said his role was pretty simple in the Flyers organization, and it looks like John Kordick has a bloody nose. You bet he does. So my role is simple. If there's a problem on the ice, I go out and fix it. And he may have just fixed a problem that was brewing as far as John Kordick taking liberties against some of the smaller Flyers a little earlier. Here's how it started. They just went out to the point together, and then it was a matter of, okay, let's not ask any questions. We kind of figured it would happen. Oh, Kordick just put his head down without getting a grip first. Boy, oh boy. And you can, I think he's already been hit. Dave Brown might have hit him with the first one or two punches right in the nose with those uppercuts.
Ooh, he was really trying to score with that one as he pulled away, wasn't he?
Yeah, but John Kordick, well, you know, as soon as he put his head down, he really couldn't see what he was grabbing or where he was grabbing. And this is when Dave Brown, now, do you think that's not a tough position to be in? Got a half Nelson on him at the same time, but still facing him. You can see that Dave Brown has him locked out so well. Kordick's punches weren't coming within 6 inches of Brown's face.